this is Afsha, English teacher at Elizabeth High School and Junior College. Welcome back to my class. Today we are going to start with the part B of unit 6 from class 8 because you have already completed the part A of our unit 6. And I hope that you all remember that the theme of our unit is art and culture. The part B is a poem actually. The name of our poem is The Earthen Goblet. So this is a very beautiful poem that is really portrayed very beautifully, we can say, and it was written by Harindranath Chattopadhyay. So before beginning with our poem, let us move forward towards the poet's introduction. Let us have a look on it. He was born on 2nd of April 1898 in Hyderabad in a Bengali Hindu Kulin Brahmin family to Agornath Chattopadhyay. So he was a native of Hyderabad itself, and his father name was Agornath Chattopadhyay and mother name was Barada Sundari Devi. He was a multi-talented personality as an Indian English poet, a dramatist, an actor, a musician and a member of the first Lok Sabha from Vijayawada constituency. So he was a very talented person actually. He was a musician, he was a poet, he was a dramatist, an actor and so on. He was the younger brother of Sarojini Naidu. So the main thing that we need to remember here is he was the younger brother of Sarojini Naidu, the Nightingale of India, the first woman president of Indian National Congress. He is famous for poems like Noon and the Shaper Shaped. So these were some of his famous writings. Now without wasting our time, let us move forward towards our poem. O silent goblet, red from head to heel, how did you feel when you were being twirled upon the potter's wheel before the potter gave you to the world? So here the poet or a man is asking a goblet, okay, that will be made up of mud actually. So the question is, how did you feel when you are being twirled in the potter's wheel? What is the feelings that are striking in your mind at that time? How did you really feel at that time before the potter gave you to the world, before going into the world of the human beings? How did you feel? Now let's see what the goblet is replying here. I felt a conscious impulse in my clay to break away. I really feel like my clay is breaking down from the great potter's hand that burns so warm. So when he was burning me so warmly, right, when I was kept in full of temperature, I felt a vast feeling of sorrow to be cast into my present form. I felt a very vast feeling of sorrow. I really felt very sad at that time to be cast into my present form. The way how I am today, I'm feeling very sad for this. Before that fatal hour that saw me captive on the potter's wheel and cast into his crimson goblet sleep, I used to feel the fragrant friendship of the little flower whose root was in my bosom buried deep. So now the goblet continued by saying that before that fatal hour, before that hour where I was placed in the high temperature that saw me captive on the potter's wheel and cast into his crimson goblet sleep, the way how I am today, I used to feel the fragrant friendship of a little flower. I really missed that, the friendship of my little flower whose root was in my bosom buried deep. The flower whose roots were buried inside me. I really missed those flowers. The potter has drawn out the living breath of me and given me a form which is the death of me. So here the goblet continued in a very serious way by saying that the potter has drawn out the living breath of me. What does it mean? I am dead now and given me a form which is the death of me. My past unshapely natural state was best. I was very happy in my past form itself with just one flower flaming through my breast. With only one flower that whose roots were buried in my heart, I was happy at that time only. So that was about our poem which was portrayed very beautifully by Harindranath Chattopadhyay. In his poem, he is just stating the pain of the soil actually, pain of the earthen goblet, how the goblet really feels after burning in the potter's hand, right? So that was all about our poem. Let us stop it here itself and we will continue in our next class. Thank you.